That's it.
Yeah.
I went to the same on the other side. I'm just all giddy.
Yeah, stop bending
That's
over.
That's okay.
Let me do it. You should probably have your oxygen up here as well. I've been really looking forward to coming at Pierre and doing some building with him. And him teaching me the ropes a little bit. But yeah, it's just wonderful to spend time with him. Obviously, you know, not to be morbid, but we don't know how much time he's got left. He's really open and frank about that. He's doing amazingly well and has been for the last couple of years. You know, he's really fighting and just wants to be here. You know, he wants to survive. He wants to live. So it's definitely made us closer in a way, because all of the falls away.
So take a day foot that way.
I don't understand how the posts go in.
No, they'll sit on top of the timber.
I see.
Yeah, I mean, it's like that. So they'll sit there against this timber, and we'll put some pins in this
side.
So it doesn't slide down. We're not damaging the floor.
Yeah.
And it's saving this timber from getting so wet.
So does that mean that there'll be... Right, I see. So these, there'll be two of these.
I thought this was going to be easy.
I knew it wasn't going to be easy.
Not with you, yeah. We had it all planned out three times now.
Did you?
Yes. Yeah. And it was half the size.
Was it?
So much easier. We were being finished now, wouldn't we?
Well, it doesn't have to be that long.
We'd have been
wide.
Enjoying
you don't
it.
Need to be that wide?
Have you not built it yet?
I know.
You've been here for 3 months.
I know.
We're still talking about
please
it.
Please come up here. Yeah, we need please. Help. So we're going to do... 12 foot.
How many bedrooms now?
Three bedrooms.
Two stories.
It's got an ensuite. Three bedrooms, ensuite.
Where's the swimming pool going?
We're okay on the swimming pool, but don't need this.
Here you go, babes.
Right.
I know he's constant bants, but Dada does have a serious side.
I know he worries about me as well. He knows that this is, like, absolutely huge. I'm putting everything on the line. I'm getting myself massively in debt in order to do this. This isn't like a pet side project with a spare million that I have. That's not the case at all. This is like all in, not just all in, but, you know, borrowing money from the banks. And he's scared about that, I think.
Are you right, Dylan?
Yeah, yeah.
But then in another way, he's like, just go for it. You only live once. But yes, I think it would be really wonderful for him to absolutely see it become a success, hopefully.
It's been a week since Dad and I started building the sleeping platform in the woods together. But we've had to pause.
Dada is okay. He couldn't come up here this week because he's not feeling well. So he thinks because of COVID, he hasn't been having the regular testing that he was having before COVID, where they test his amyloid levels and in all. So the amyloidosis is the disease that he's got. And it's a misfolding protein, and so they test his amyloid levels in all of his organs. But they haven't been doing it, and so he's been getting really tired, really breathless, and that's a sign that it's building up again, basically. The only treatment for it is chemotherapy. Where I am with it at the moment is that I try not to think about the inevitable, because I've thought about it loads and it didn't help. We could finish it with Bubsy or the Carpenters, but it's not right. This is my dad's thing.
In the woods, thankfully my dad didn't need chemo, so he's back to finish the sleeping platform with me, doing his best tubby cowboy impression.
What you got there now? That's nice. That'll be good.
Yeah. So it's like a working paraffin lamp?
Yeah, is that just... We've just got one of you?
Four.
Oh, great.
One for each. This is what we're going to sleep under if it's raining.
Do you think it'll rain, yeah?
Just a little bit.
Pull it back out now. Yeah, see, you're just getting rid of all the... Because it's wet. That's okay.
Yeah?
And then you go on that one.
Ooh.
We're thinking, looking at it now, is it long enough? Look, if I'm laying down and I'm short, you know, if you're laying down, don't lay down, but if you are, if you're laying down, you're...
I cut my legs off.
It's lovely, because you haven't been able to be up here for a couple of weeks.
No, I was gutted. I couldn't come back up here.
Yeah.
But now we're up here. It's great. It's like a little haven.
And how are you feeling?
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Great.
All right.
Marvellous.
Managing.
Yeah. Managing.
Yeah, we're doing okay. Wait, I don't want a hug. I don't want a hug. Yeah, go on, at the bottom one.
Personally, I can't wait to get out and sleep here once it's done. Although, my dad's not so keen.
I don't want to stay here.
I know you don't.
What do you mean? I don't want to stay in the woods. I want to be in one of your nice bedrooms.
I'm staying in a hotel.
You're fucking it behind you.
I'm staying in a hotel. I'm not staying here.
Oh, hilarious.
I'm quite surprised how well it looks. Really surprised. I'm really pleased with it. I've actually finished something I started here. It doesn't look too bad, does it?
We've got it looking quite level, really, considering there wasn't a spirit level in sight, or...?
No, because I think it'll be stunning in the night with the glow and with the forest and everything else.
Should we go for lunch?
OK.
It looks delightful. I'm chuffed to bits with what my dad and I have made. Now all I've got to do is the finishing touches.
Should we bring the mattresses up?
Mm-hmm.
What an enchanting place to come and reflect and reconnect with nature.
I don't think that my interest in healing is to do necessarily with the fact that I was a famous child or anything like that, because I mean, I had a ball for the majority of the time. You know, I travelled the world and I sang with orchestras, and it was hard, and the press stuff was really difficult when I was a teenager and in my early 20s and being a young mother, and that was all a lot. But I mean, I think it's more just to do with the trauma. Everybody's got it. It's ten a penny, you know? And for some people, that trauma is really big, terrible abuse, terrible neglect. For other people, it's much smaller.
Nature soothes us. It's peaceful and helps us deal with whatever we've got going on in our lives.
I'm on my own journey, I think, of unblocking myself, you know, working through trauma, childhood, all of it, the same as everybody, really. But I just feel really lucky to have started that process, because so many people haven't even started the process. My neighbour said something, the only way out is through, and the only way through is back. Sort of meaning that you have to go back into your past.
They look great, don't they? Not wanting to risk Dad's health, he'll be kipping inside whilst I kutch up and bathe in the forest.
It is also soaking.
Yes, it's raining, but that only adds to the ambiance.
So this is the outdoor sleeping shelter, and it is a huge success, I feel. And it just feels really cushy and lush. It's all that I'd imagined, really. I mean, I will tinker till the cows come home. I'm a terrible tinkerer. So I'll definitely, you know, we'll have more places for candles to go, which feel a little bit safer, and probably have them in little hurricane jars and stuff, so it's a bit less of a fire risk with an open flame. But it's lush, it's really nice, and it's lush that my dad built it too.
Right, not for a kip now, not star.